I know the headline shocked me. People are mad at Ellen DeGeneres.
It's happened before. It's rare, but it has happened before.
So Ellen DeGeneres was hanging out at an NFL football game. She was at the Cowboys suite. She's at the Cowboys Packers game, and she's in the Cowboys suite, and she's sitting next to former President Bush. All right, and she's on her phone. He's sitting next to her. They're smiling. Of course, inevitably, the cameras are going to pan to them and show them. So everybody saw Ellen, who is very liberal, hanging out with a conservative former president. And they were upset with her, okay?
I mean, what's she supposed to do?
Yeah.
I get up and just walk out. Yeah. Or like, when he starts talking, just put your hand up, like, talk to the hand. I
mean, she's not known for causing conflict. She's known for, like, giving away SUVs and dancing. She dances and she smiles at people.
So this is how she addressed it on her show.
People were upset. They thought, why is a gay Hollywood liberal sitting next to a conservative Republican president? But a lot of people were mad, and they did what people do when they're mad. They tweet, I'm friends with George Bush, and I'm friends with a lot of people who don't share the same beliefs that I have. We're all different, and I think that we've forgotten that that's okay that we're all different. But just because I don't agree with someone on everything doesn't mean that I'm not going to be friends with them. When I say be kind to one another, I don't mean only the people that think the same way that you do. I mean be kind to everyone.
Amen. Somehow, somewhere, it has been twisted that when you disagree with somebody, you also can't respect them. I've said this before, that being in the middle now is taking a side. And people want to be mad at each other for whatever reason. There is nothing wrong with two people that come from completely different backgrounds or have different opinions hanging out with each other and listening and respecting each other.
I think she crushed this. I don't know. It's like people would rather live in an echo chamber today and only be around people who have the same opinions as you. But there's no growth in that. Like, there's nothing wrong with this. Bert waxes his butt. I don't look at him any differently. It's
yes,
fine.
You do.
You know? Yeah, you do.
I feel like the last 20 minutes.
It was
a regrettable overshare. I don't know that the chemistry on the show is ever going to be the same.
I already knew this about you, so it's fine.
Right.
After that, and I listened to Ellen's response, and I thought it was beautiful, and I thought she nailed it. And then I'm on Twitter, and I see some people's responses to Ellen, and they still don't agree with her. So I follow a comedy writer, and Megan posted this: "You can't be nice to everyone, because being nice to certain people is inherently cruel to others."
Mm. Mm.
And that, she's got a point. Yeah, I hate to admit it, but she's got a point. Like, people who are homophobic and, you know, people who are bigots. Like, there is a point there.
Yeah, somebody pointed out, like, why would you sit next to someone that literally started a war? You know, and I'm like, oy.
I can't take responsibility for the entire world. I can't.
Yeah. I get that.
All I can do now, my answer to that would be, well, maybe I can kill them with kindness. And maybe by them talking, he would have a different opinion that he would have before.
Are you going to sit down and be nice to a racist?
I mean,
these are questions
actually,
to ponder.
I would, because a lot of times I think that people who are racist may have had bad experiences like we all have, and sometimes really all it takes is for them to see, like, a black person who is not the stereotypical black person that they may have in their mind, and it may actually help them change their opinion. And if it doesn't, that's on them. But that's all I can do is present, you know, what I believe to be the best thing for them to change their opinion.
I don't think it's really, like, she's not preaching forgiveness. She's just preaching tolerance.
Uh-huh.
Like, you can sit next to someone, but I don't know. I feel like people are just finding it unforgivable for her to do that.
I mean, it's not like they were funneling beers together.
Right.
They did. They just didn't get that on camera.
Because I know the former president could pound himself some beers. I know that's right.
The Bert Show.